A very good day to you. My name is Brighton Nuba. This is Asake Online. Today marks 1 year after the polls, 1 year after we cast our vote to elect councillors, MPs, and also president of this country. A lot is happening across the year, and we have seen different people being elected into office, becoming mayors of different cities, and a cabinet has been elected as well, and some government has taken over, such like chairmanship. And today we reflect to see, after the 1 year has been done, what has been achieved by our MPs, what has been achieved by our councillors across the country. And to give us today the State of the Constituency address is going to be Honorable Desire Moyo, coming from Nkulumane Constituency. A lot has been done there as well in terms of the development and so on. But today I want to hear from his heart what has been done and what are these plans for the next coming 4 years. Good morning to you, Honorable MP. Over to you. You can address the people from Nkulumane.
Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to celebrate 365 days working together with the people of Nkulumane, Ward 23 and Ward 22, together with the two councillors, Ward 23, Umama Ntomzotha Khumalo, and Ward 22, Councillor Meli Thobeka Moyo. The 365 days have been a period of setting up foundations, have been a period of practicalizing the theory that we had, the promises that we had during the election time. What we have done so far is to bring together the people of Nkulumane, uniting them, closing the gaps, and also creating very vibrant development pillars in the form of the development committee, as well as the combustion team, to serve the social fabric, to bring together the people and also to stand with them in times of sorrow and happiness. What we have done as Nkulumane, we have come together as 11 concrete structures. These structures, they are the women structure, the youth structure, the men structure, the religious leaders structure, the square leaders structure, those abagazi buthe. We also have the war veterans structure. We also have the youth structure. We also have the CSOs, the NGOs structure, those that are working within Nkulumane. We also have the social services cluster and the security cluster as well, those that are into neighborhood in safeguarding our constituency during the night. These clusters have formed what we call the Constituency Development Committee, which was our first mandate and our first promise to the people of Nkulumane, to make Nkulumane a very communicative community through these vibrant and practical development structures. So far, these structures, they've come together to produce what we call the Nkulumane Constituency Development Plan, which is a five-year plan towards development and also uplifting the lives of Nkulumane residents. So the development plan covers a very lot of a roadmap in terms of where we need to go in the next 5 years, together with our leadership across all our sectors of the constituency. I am very happy to say, as the people of Nkulumane, we have managed to close gaps, the political gaps. Our development committee consists of a lot of people from across the political divide. We have people from different political parties, and I'm happy to say the leadership of the development committee comes from a different party where I come from, as well as the organizing office for the constituency is also from a different party. So I am happy that the people of Nkulumane have managed to cultivate a rainbow constituency culture, and I'm proud of that. This has seen us bringing together people from all walks of life, as well as from the religious sectors. We have churches coming up together to unite and also have a plan for Nkulumane. So this far, we have managed to create a structured Nkulumane, so we know who to contact, when, and on which numbers to contact them. So this was fundamental for the Nkulumane constituents, because over the years, we have just had an office of the MP with a PA or secretary at the office. But now I can tell you, we have office of the MP right across the two wards. So we are reachable, we are available all the time to assist and also facilitate development. And secondly, as Nkulumane, we have managed to also create a compassion team. This is a team of 15 men and women who represent the office of the MP in times of sorrow or bereavement, where we lose our loved ones. We've realized that we've faced a lot of challenges in the form of losing our loved ones, and there are number of funerals that have befallen our constituency, and those are the crucial times of need. This is when, as Abantu, Ubuntu will call us to sizohlanganisa amehlo abanye ngababamba izandla. So we need to be together during this time, and we've created a specific pillar to support each and every one of us, Nkulumane. These two pillars have seen us working together and making efforts to remain steadfast even in the face of challenges. This, from Nkulumane, has cultivated a participatory community where everyone is involved. From the youth in schools, from the kindergarten, the ECDs, we have managed to have all the voices coming into the play to forge a way forward for Nkulumane. These two pillars have taught, together with the MP, all the institutions within Nkulumane. We have just concluded the MP familiarization tour of the constituency. I took with me the three executives from the development committee, the combustion team, and of course the CTF committee, which is a committee that oversees the government fund through parliament for the development of the constituency. So we have taught all of the eight primary schools in Nkulumane. We have taught the only high school that we have in Nkulumane, that is Nkulumane High School. We've met the administration of the school and also the parents' administration of the school, which is the SDCs and the SDAs, school development associations, within the nine schools that we have. We have listened to them, we've engaged, we've interfaced, and we've come to realize a lot of challenges that our academic institutions are facing, which is making it difficult for the learners and the teachers to operate, to learn and to teach. So these are the challenges that we have confronted as the office of the MP and the development pillars that we established as the people of Nkulumane. So now that we have gathered enough information on the challenges, we are now forging a way forward to say, how then do we embark on the resource mobilization to then address the challenges that our learners are facing in the schools? We've realized that there are water challenges across all of the institutions, the learning institutions in our constituency. We've also realized that there is a challenge of furniture, and also the ECT blocks in the primary schools. Some have managed to build those, but there are outstanding issues. It might be roofing or the latrines. So these are the challenges that we've come across within our learning institutions. Together with the development pillars and the Office of MP, we have also taught the two police stations within our constituency. We have Chabalala Police Station, and also we have Nkulumane Police Station, which is in Pelandaba Chabalala, but also it's our constituency falls under their eyes. So we have realized also after engagement with the officials at the two police stations, that there is a lot that the constituency, the people of Nkulumane, need to do to close gaps and also to work hand in hand with the police, so that we make Nkulumane a safe destination for everyone and a safe place for everyone. So we are currently working on how best we can hold a crime indaba, which is a big event that is coming this September, and we are yet to announce the date, where we're going to come together as the people of Nkulumane, the office of the MP, and also the police from Chabalala and Nkulumane, to say how can we fight crime within our area. So we have had challenges from the police, the rape issues, robberies, you know, theft, and you know, a lot of human rights violations as people try to make a living, unfortunately, on the wrong side of the law. So this is, we are going to work together with the police and also with the development committee and the combustion team, so that we make Nkulumane a safe base. for everyone. So this is what we've done. We've also visited the two clinics within Nkulumane constituency. That is Ward 22, we have Nkulumane Clinic, and Ward 23, Makawe Clinic. We've met officials and administrators from the two clinics, and we have gathered enough to make those clinics viable and also of good service to the people of Nkulumane. So this far we have gone. We have managed to look into the issues, the health, education and security sector, to see how best Nkulumane can be a home for everyone. So I am happy that the constituency, the residents are very cooperative. We have also harnessed the power of the business community, supporting our familiarization tour and also supporting our two endeavors that we have done so far in March and also on May 25, when we unveiled these pillars of development to the people of Nkulumane. Now, the way forward. The fact that now we have created Nkulumane as a communicative community and also as a participatory community, we have harnessed everyone to come on board to set up and also to identify areas of development. We are now setting out to mobilize resources. We are now going all out to invite the business community. We are now going all out to invite all the sons and daughters of Nkulumane who are outside our borders, be it in South Africa or beyond, even overseas in diaspora, to say, let us remember our sons and daughters, our friends, our colleagues, our parents, and our grannies in Nkulumane. How best can we support Nkulumane so that we make Nkulumane proud again? So between now and the next 365 days, I am sure, working together with the development committee and also the compassion team, and finally the CTF committee, we are going to be inviting, we are going to be luring well-wishers to come and help us build Nkulumane. Nkulumane needs a lot of development in terms of the road infrastructure, which is what we are looking at together with our two councillors, Umama Untomzoto Kumalo, Lo Jaha, or Councillor Umeli Moyo. We are all out to engage with the city council to also look into our roads and also look into potential sites where we can drill boreholes, maybe through the CTF for our schools, maybe for our police stations as well. We are also working all out to look into the elders within our Nkulumane constituency. We want to establish a fund that will look into the elders abasen Nkulumane. So the development committee has a cluster, a social services cluster, that will look into the livelihoods of abadala abasebekhulile 65 years and above. We're going to be working with the city council and also working with the respective ministry of government to say, how best can we assist abadala bethu? Abadala bethu, they have a lot of challenges. Abanye behlezi ezindlini with no one to look after them. So as the office of the MP, together with the people's committees that we have established, we want to take care of our elders, abasen Nkulumane. So we are going all out to create a database to assist them. And also, for the next 365 days, we want to see the development committee, hand in glove, working with the CTF, to also look into the issues of security. We want to help facilitate the establishment of neighborhood committees throughout all the wards, throughout all the communities within Nkulumane. This will help us curb crime. 2 weeks ago, after having met the Nkulumane police officers, we agreed that there is need to have residents working with the police. I had the time 2 weeks back to just move around at night around Nkulumane constituency, and I was happy to see about 5 neighborhood committees going around at night, and I happened to have one incident where in Ward 23 the neighborhood committee had a challenge after catching red-handedly some thieves who were carrying some gadgets in the middle of the night. They had to call the police station, and the police officers, they had no transport to come to the scene. And I myself had to drive the neighborhood team together with the gadgets that they'd recovered after the thieves had to run away to the police station. So this shows that we are not yet safe as Nkulumane. So we need to facilitate and also to support such kind of security measures within our constituency. We are going to establish neighborhood committees, watch committees, together with Osbute, the square leaders within our constituency, so that we are all safe. We know others work at night. Abantu abasebenza ebusuku bengena ama night shift, they need to be safe eNkulumane. And even those cars abajovisayo ababuya eNkulumane, be it ama combis or ama Honda Fits, I know there are taxis abajova ebusuku be transport our residents after imsebenza ethile kuma night shifts. So they also equally need to be safe, and we want to assure abantu bonke that eNkulumane will be a safe zone that far. So this is what we're going to be practically doing, and also guided by the Nkulumane Constituency Development Plan that was devised by the people of Nkulumane themselves on March 24 and also launched on May 25. I can assure the people of Nkulumane that the office of the MP is not an individual, and it will never again be an individual. Even for those yet to come, we have created structures and pillars that will tap into the people of Nkulumane and also give feedback as well. So this is what we expect to achieve as Abantu beNkulumane, and to make Nkulumane proud again. Thank you so much. I wish you a very fruitful journey for the next 365 days to mark our 2-year anniversary working together in an open door policy. Ngiyabonga.
There you have it. That is Honorable Desire Moyo, coming from Nkulumane constituency, says, let's make Nkulumane great again. He's delivering State of the Constituency address this afternoon, right here at Cite. So if you guys enjoyed that discussion there, and also, do you guys know your MP? 1 year later, do you guys know your MPs? Do you guys even see your MPs in your constituency? Are they even coming to you to give you feedback meetings on what they're discussing in Parliament? And there are many people that even don't know their MPs and their councillors. I hope you guys reflect and also attend these meetings in your constituencies. Get to know your councillors, get to know your MPs, and get to ask questions in terms of development in your constituency. That was Desire Moyo there speaking to us, delivering the State of the Constituency address right here side to people from Nkulumane. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. And please do pass your comments via DMs, via your feedback. Your site, we're willing to see also and listen to your DMs. Do follow us on all platforms, Twitter, Facebook, TikTok. We are there to hear all the stories and also to give you all the stories from myself, Brighton Ncube. It's bye for now.